this Peachtree City teacher loves doing improv comedy, but hearing loss made it tough for her to keep up on stage. Well, the Fox Medical Team's Beth Galvin has her story coming up later on Fox 5 News at 5.
And up next, improv comedy requires a lot of fast thinking back and forth. But this Peachtree City teacher felt like she was dropping the ball because of her hearing loss. Fox Medical Team's Beth Galvin shows us how she got back in the game right after the break. About 15% of American adults have some form of hearing loss.
Yeah, and the problem often evolves so gradually that people don't even realize they have a problem until their hearing loss is severe. Well, the Fox Medical Team's Beth Galvin is here with the story of one Peachtree City teacher. Beth?
And Sine and Tom, Amy Beecham first noticed that she had a problem with her hearing in her late 50s because she would find herself asking her students to repeat themselves. But the issue really became obvious on stage, doing improvisational comedy, because Beecham began to realize she may be dropping the ball.
Yeah, just have a seat, young lady, please.
Amy Beecham loves the fly-by-the-seat-of-your-pants world of improv comedy, like this skit where she's in the hot seat being interrogated but has no idea why.
What about technology?
The 61-year-old's part of an improv group, the Nitwits, who meet Saturdays here at Noonan Community Theater, working without a script or a safety net, playing entirely off each other.
You have to listen.
The word is science.
That is light number one.
They call me the science.
If you're not listening,
the word is guitar.
You're not going to be able to be the best partner for your other actors.
And Amy, your word is beetle.
But 3 years ago, Beecham began to realize she couldn't hear what other people were saying. She first noticed the problem at work, teaching gifted students at Peachtree City's Kedron Elementary.
I would have to literally walk up to students at their desk and say, "What was that?" You know, which really interfered in my teaching.
And here in the spotlight, Beecham was missing cues, so she decided she had to do something.
Because I didn't want them to have to kindly ask me to bow out, because I was making mistakes on stage.
How about the amp?
Beecham came to Beltone Hearing Aid Center in Peachtree City, where Jared Babb, a licensed hearing instrument specialist, says he sees a lot of people who delay getting help for hearing loss.
Most of our patients have waited. I think the average is around 8-9 years before they do anything about it.
Beecham needed hearing aids in both ears, so Bob recommended the Beltone Legend, a system designed for iPhone users like her.
You can adjust whenever you need to. You don't have to fool around with hearing aids, take them out.
She can control the volume, sound filters, everything with an app on her phone, and she can even listen to audiobooks or music using her hearing aids, and no one can tell.
Everybody's on their phone now, so nobody's going to know you're dealing with hearing aids when you're on your phone.
And now that Beecham can hear more clearly, she says it's easier to keep up with the back and forth on stage.
Because that's what improv is all about. Listening and respond. Listen and react.
And it's nice, Amy Beecham says, to feel like she's finally back in on the jokes.
And I didn't know how much I was missing. That's the thing. You don't realize how much you're missing until you get this intervention.
And surveys show that many people who could actually benefit from having a hearing aid aren't using one. Only a third of adults who are over the age of 70 who could use a hearing aid actually have ever used one, and only 16% of adults who are in their 60s and younger who could benefit from a hearing aid have used one. So Tom and Sine, there's a lot of people I think that are out there that are sort of gradually losing their hearing, but thinking maybe they don't have options, or maybe they're not actually realizing it.
And the other thing I think is sometimes vanity. People think, oh, I don't want an ugly hearing aid in my ear, but the advancements,
times have changed.
They're really small now.
Absolutely, yes. So, you know, it's not obvious anymore.
Definitely. Thanks so much, Beth.
Thank you, Beth.